Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. This week we are going to be talking about everything you need as a beginner digital artist to get started on this journey. Now, my name is Kayla. I go by Kayla Creative online. And if you don't know me already, I'm a full-time iPad artist that helps other creatives just like me learn how to make an income from their iPads through digital art. If that sounds like a cool lifestyle to you, then make sure you subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications so that you'll know every time I post a new resource. Now, in this line of work, I talk to a lot of beginner artists, and one of their number one questions for me is, what are the tools that they need to get started on a digital art journey? What do I use to create my art? So I put together this video and I'm gonna give you a couple of my top recommendations, but I also wanna tell you about another resource I have. In the description of this video and also in the comments, you're gonna see a link to download my free digital art starter pack. I've packed it full with all the gear, all the brushes, and some of the resources that have been really, really helpful for me to get started. And if you're a newbie, I bet they'd be helpful for you too. But without further ado, let's go into some of my top recommendations for the tools that you'll need to get started making digital art. The first thing is your hardware. You're gonna need some type of drawing tablet or hardware to create art on. My recommendation is the iPad. I use an iPad Pro 11-inch with the second generation Apple Pencil to draw all of my work. Now, a question that you might have or that you're gonna start seeing online as you research digital art is, does the screen size matter? My suggestion to you is to just start with the iPad that you can afford. Mine is the iPad Pro 11-inch. I find that this screen is a perfect size for me. Some people prefer larger sizes, but you can get some really beautiful work done on an 11-inch screen. So if that fits your budget, I would suggest that you start there. The second thing that you're gonna need is some type of drawing app to put on your iPad. I love Procreate. You can find the Procreate app in the App Store. It's for iOS or iPad only. It costs $9.99. That's a one-time flat fee. And after you pay that, Procreate and all of the updates that come along with it will be yours forever. I love the brushes that Procreate has to offer. I love the layer modes. I love the blending modes. No, this is not sponsored, but I have had a wonderful time creating digital art with Procreate. So that is my recommendation to you, along with the iPad, to get started. Now, if you don't have an iPad, but you do have an iPhone, I would suggest that you go in the App Store and search for Procreate Pocket. This is Procreate's phone app that you can use as an alternative to the full Procreate iPad app. It still has plenty of fun features. There is a one-time cost for this app of $4.99, and you can draw through a stylus on your phone screen, or I know plenty of artists who also just draw with their finger. So it's a wonderful alternative. Now, let me stop here and tell you that the iPad and Procreate are not the only hardware and software options for making digital art. If you want to learn a little bit more about the other options that are available to you that other artists use to create gorgeous work, I would suggest watching Nadia Axel's video, which is called A Beginner's Guide to Become a Digital Artist Part 1. I'll also link that in the description below. All right, now if you've decided that your team iPad and team Procreate just like me, then the next thing I wanna do is suggest to you some brushes to get started with your digital work on Procreate. My very favorites are Dizzy Terra's Oval Sketch Brush 2 and Cassavet's The Everything Brush. These are both paid brushes that I'll link in the description of this video, and you can find them on Gumroad. They are my favorite brushes to use for line work, and I use them for just about all the line work that I draw these days. Now, there are plenty of free brushes that already come with Procreate. Some of my favorite free brushes are the Soft Airbrush and also the syrup brush, which is in Procreate's inking section. I use that to put flat color on all of my work. Now, don't forget to grab your digital art starter pack, again, link in the video description, because it's going to go through all of the brushes that I suggest for line work, for flat color, and for details like highlights and shadows, and I don't want you to miss out on that. So now you've got your iPad, you've got Procreate, you've got some brushes downloaded and ready to go, and you are ready to start your digital art journey. The last thing that you're gonna wanna do is find some drawing resources, some learning resources, so that you can get well on your way with learning how to make art on the iPad. There are plenty of artists that you can look to for this who have Patreons and YouTube tutorials, including myself, so be sure that you subscribe to my channel where I'll be sharing lots of resources to help you get started and, again, help you make an income from your iPad through digital art. Now that you've got all that information, I want to wish you the best of luck on your digital art journey. Find me on Instagram, tag me in the pieces that you make, and send me a DM so I can send you back a really big congratulations. Now, if this video was helpful for you, please tap the thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more. See you next time.